I'm sexy and I know it.
So Rachel, how was your weekend?
Well, you know, it could have been spectacular since we had prom, you know. But of course, I failed that cell communication test.
Really? I failed it too.
Oh my gosh, I got a 20 out of 60.
I got even worse than that. I got a 12.
So embarrassing.
I know. And I heard Scott and Connor both got like 53s. That's an A.
Scott and Connor?
Yeah, they
beat us. The doofuses that sit in the back?
Yeah, seriously, it's so embarrassing.
What?
Do you think they could like tutor us?
Maybe. Oh my gosh, that's such a good idea. Because we have a retake next week.
Yeah, I'm gonna call
him. Alright.
What's up, guys?
Hi, Connor.
Hey, Connor. Thanks for coming to help us out.
No problem. So you guys really thought it was that hard?
Yeah. Really? Seriously, like, it was the hardest thing I've ever done.
Really?
Yeah.
Because me and Scott work together.
Oh, hey, Scott.
Hi, Scott.
And hey, guys.
Thanks for coming.
And we thought it was the easiest thing ever.
What you guys have a problem on?
Everything.
Everything.
Really? Because if you think about it, it's really a lot like Facebook.
Really? But I have a Facebook and it's so easy to use, but I don't know a thing about cell communication.
Yeah, me neither.
We can show you. Come on.
Okay.
Well, ask us any question about cell communication and we'll tell you how it's like Facebook.
Okay, well, I remember having a lot of problems with the differences and similarities between local regulators and hormones.
Really? That's understandable because they're so similar, but there's significant differences between the two.
Exactly. They're similar in the fact that both transmit signals to and from the cell.
Oh, no wonder I was so confused.
Yeah, the difference between the two is that hormones are for long-distance signaling, and local regulators are for cells that are located near the cell transmitting the signal.
Right, I guess it kind of makes sense now, but how does it relate to Facebook?
Well, you gotta think of it like comments and statuses. When you update a status, it's sent out to everyone's news feed, which is sort of like hormones when you think about it.
Oh, yeah.
But then with local regulators, it's more like comments, because when you comment on a person's personal page, it only affects their page.
Oh my gosh, it totally makes sense now. If only Mr. Jeffrey had explained it that way, I wouldn't have failed.
Alright, I got that. But what are the three stages of cell signaling?
Well, that's the easiest part, my phone. It goes reception, which is like on Facebook when you get a notification.
And then comes transduction, when the message is sent out and processed into a form where that can be carried out. So like when you click on the notification, you see 50 people liked it on your profile pic from prom.
And lastly comes response, which is how you react to the notification.
So, it's kind of like when I think how popular and pretty I am because 50 people liked my Facebook picture from prom.
Exactly.
Oh, I know what you mean now.
Okay, look, I totally found this other part that I completely bombed. What is a ligand?
Well, it induces change in receptors' conformations. Sort of like how when you comment on someone else's comment, and other people see it and are inclined to comment back.
But what does the G protein-linked receptor do? How does that tie in?
Oh, well, it activates the receptor, which then binds to it and activates a specific G protein, right there, which then activates membrane-bound enzymes, which hydrolyzes its GTP and becomes inactive again, triggering the next step in the pathway to the cell's responses.
Gotcha.
I never knew that.
Me neither. But then what's tyrosine kinase have to do with it?
Well, it triggers many transduction pathways. In terms of Facebook, it's like sending out a group message, and when you send out to a large message, you trigger multiple pathways which trigger then multiple different responses.
I never thought about it that way. It makes way more sense to me now.
But how do ligand-gated ion channels work?
Much like how privacy settings work on Facebook, by allowing specific ions to pass, which is like how you can make it so only your friends on Facebook can see your posts. Unless, of course, you have secret friends in the CIA like Mr. Jeffrey.
Oh man, I wish I knew that earlier, but I still don't understand protein kinases.
Well, think of it like Facebook chatting and Twitter. Every message you send out is then relayed down a pathway to a specific cell, or in modern terms, message that is typed and sent into a specific person.
I know what you mean. Thank you so much, but I still need help with a few more things, like protein phosphatases.
They're just enzymes that shut down signaling pathways. Much like the delete comment button on Facebook, allowing you to completely shut down a signaling pathway.
Makes sense. But what are secondary messengers?
Well, they work to rapidly relay received messages by membrane-bound receptors. First messengers, these are most commonly associated with cyclic AMP, which are binding of a signal to its G protein, which causes it to activate adrenaline cyclase. It is very similar to how you tag someone in a post.
Okay, I kind of see now. But what is signal amplification, and how does it deal with scaffolding proteins?
Well, signal amplification is when a successful enzyme in a pathway can activate multiple enzymes of the next step.
And scaffolding proteins are just large relay proteins that bind to proteins and help increase efficiency signal transduction, which is like on Facebook when someone is trying to bring light on a situation. So when people like a post, it helps increase the awareness of the case. An example of this is the Kony 2012 campaign.
I know cell communication.
Oh my gosh, it all makes sense.
We're gonna pass the retake.
Totally.
Do you really think so?
Yes.
Yeah.
Ran into a rocko in my restroom. Singer slash actress in my bedroom. Got a half a ticket for a walkthrough. Everything I do is big. We all talk about.